DSTV's production of Summer Season is brought to you by The Block Nutrition. Tired and drained after a hot summer day? Come to The Block Nutrition for a refreshing, loaded tea or hydration, because The Block is always hot.
Great at home, you're great at school, you're great in athletics, it just becomes natural just to be your best. And that's been a lot of fun to watch that mentality change, because it has changed here. You can see it, you can feel it, you can walk these hallways, you can feel it.
We have such a good culture that kids want to stick around and be around us. You know, we have 136 players just 10 through 12 right now, not counting the 75 incoming freshmen. And they want to be around us, and they want to be around the sport, be around the game, be here at Denham Springs, proud to wear Denham Springs colors, proud to be a part of it.
I've been around other places, and what I've found here is that the culture is so positive, and everybody's so excited to be part of it. The kids have fun, and it makes it a fun atmosphere to play in. They work hard together, they build a brotherhood together. We have a clear culture of what's acceptable behavior and what's not, and what's acceptable is working your butt off, having fun, being positive with your buddies, and it makes it such a great place to be.
You know, I don't want to just be good in one or two sports. Like, I pride myself. I watch it every year, trying to get all nine of our teams that are in the PowerPoint system in the playoffs. I want everybody to be successful. I want all these kids to, when they start breeding that energy, that championship mentality, that winning mentality, the work mentality that goes into success, well, that trickles over into the school. So not only is your athletic department great, your school is great.
And I've been around schools where we won a lot, went to the Dome and stuff like that. And the atmosphere of the school gets better immediately. The academics in schools with positive, like, football teams that do well, the academics actually go up. The football players, if you have a good atmosphere, become the leaders in the school. A positive and good, successful football season leads to, you know, success for the school as a whole.
Of course, when you're having success and everybody's a part of it and watching it, you begin to want that. You know, you do come out and you see thousands of people packed in the stands, and you see us get to the third round. Well, those students that are in that student section that play other sports, they see that, they want that, and they're driven to be better. You know, competing at a high level, giving these kids something to be proud of, a pride in our school, a pride in our community.
You know, the biggest thing I want to see is the student section. You know, there's years where it's really, really good. There's years where it's, you know, it's okay, student section. But from top to bottom, five stories the whole way up, I want to see the thing full every Friday night. You know, people used to be fearful of coming to Denham Springs because the student section was so rowdy.
What people tend to either misunderstand or don't really recognize as much as we need to is just how much of an impact the young men and women that are in athletics and extracurriculars really, period, have on the rest of campus. You know, the life lessons and the leadership that they're building and crafting, you know, you don't really understand the impact you have, whether that be through words, simple gestures, actions you take. These people on this campus look up to you, and really argue this community looks up to you more than you realize. For us as adult leaders, it's important for us to be able to tell these young men and women just how important it is to maximize the gifts, talents, abilities, opportunities they've been blessed with, but also go out and use those and actively make a change they want to be a part of in society. And I think this place does a great job in maximizing that and also providing opportunities for them to do that.
Even when I was here as a student, as a player, and you know, my senior year was the first time Denham Springs went to the playoffs since 1995. So a 13-year drought, and I saw a lot of that bringing the old Denham Springs back, and it was even more of it this past year. We have support from the students, and you know, we need to do a better job athletically as a whole to support each other. You know, it really starts at the first sport you have, and that's Friday night.
Old and new have to get on board and be excited about that. Look, I'm just as excited about the old gold helmet as I am the new purple and white helmet, because it's really not necessarily the color of the helmet, it's what's on the side of the helmet. You know, the stripe combination in these jerseys, you know, they're all a little bit different. They've all been tweaked over the years, but they're all tweaked for the better of Denham Springs, and they're all part of the blood, sweat, and tears that came before. 125 years worth of work still comes out on a Friday night at Denham Springs. I do believe that this thing here is starting to get big. It's starting to grow.
Not saying we've moved past that and forgot about our past, but it's time to rewrite, you know, a new history for Denham Springs.
Every day I walk around, you can, like I said, you can just feel it. There's a sense of there's a sense of growth, there's a sense of a positive energy, a mentality that was not here.
You see that being built with all the sports. You know, I think we have phenomenal head coaches here in all of our sports. They're getting everyone on the path that Coach Beard has built for us since he got here in 2019, 2020. Just building up that culture of being one of the most powerful and dominant schools in the state of Louisiana, as we should be, one of the biggest.
Watch what's being done in Denham Springs, because if you live here, old or new, this is a special place, and it's an amazing place, and it's really beginning to flourish. And, you know, it's my job now to continue the growth, but sustain the growth and elevate it year in and year out. You know, sometimes you get wrapped up in the 7-on-7 and the skill guys. Everybody talks about the receivers and running backs and quarterbacks. We got two big-time DBs everybody talks about. But at the end of the day, I tell our O-line, you don't know – without a snap, without a protection, without a block, you don't even know who these kids are. You know, the O-line is going to pave the way. The trenches are what's going to – is where you're going to win. You look at the third round last year. Rustin was just better in the trenches. Plain as day. Our skill guys could match up with just about anybody. But the trenches are what separated us from the teams that are in the dome right now. And that's what we have to embrace. And then we got to embrace it with all new guys. So you bring Adam White back, who's got a great rapport with these kids. One thing with Adam is a real technician. He's really technique sound O-line guy. But what makes Adam really good is Adam's really in tune with the kids. He loves the kids. He gets to know the kids. They go eat with the kids. And he's a very spiritual guy that's really in tune with each and every one of his O-linemen.
I want to go ahead and again say thank you very much. Very blessed and honored and privileged to be back here. Work for Mr. Howard again, administration, all those great men and women that invest in these young men and women, obviously, and student-athletes around the school. And I have Coach Beard. Obviously, this is actually my third tour for Coach Beard. Working with Live Oak here 2 years ago in 2021.
He's going to make him better in every facet. Which is why he's the only guy I would hire three times in my career to this point. He's the only guy I've hired three times and probably wouldn't hire many more like I did him.
I think one thing we challenge the kids with is not to think about it as rebuilding, it's more retooling. You know, the standard expectations are in place and it's up to us to be able to live up to it and exceed it and continue to build upon, again, the foundation we talk about a lot. It would be ignorant to not say there's a challenge in meshing a new group together, but at the same time, the prior group and the prior coaches and everybody that had that prior impact, to me, have done a great job in establishing, we talked about that culture just now. These guys want work. They want to be here. They want to make sure they can continue to put in the work and the effort and the sweat equity of continue to earn the abilities they have.
Gather feet, I don't want to get near. And then strike. Remember, I don't want to be in a receiver sprint, but I want to be fast enough in a second level. I'm loading up, I'm going here.
Beginning of June to now, it's a completely different team. We had just gotten the new coach with Coach White. He just came back from another school and he definitely knows what he's talking about, and he's very good with getting us all to soak up information well. And with our first five linemen, we've gone from scratch to much, much, much better with this new playbook.
Past summer, it's been great. We've been locking it in mentally, physically, and we've gotten a lot better from the beginning of the summer.
Well, since the start, we've been working pretty hard. We haven't had any easy days, any light days. We come out here, we work, we push each other. We don't let each other slack off. And we just continue to grow to the end because we know we got a goal in store at the end. So just keep working towards that.
So many names we could talk about because there's a lot of young dudes that are on the cusp of being really great, from going to be sophomores to seniors that have waited their time.
Guys like K. Marbaro, who's going to be a senior in this year, 2 years ago, and he's a sophomore, for example. You know, normal sophomore kid, nice, well-spoken kid, well-mannered. He's got a mean streak now. You know, I think he's finally starting to come into his own with the opportunity laid in front of him to be able to step up and be that guy. Same thing with Jaden Buchanan. I think Jaden's always been very physically talented and had to kind of put it together, and now you get to see that fruition, coming in.
I've been working on my kick slide and my post to punch because my tempo is really off. So I've been trying to fix that, and it's gotten better as I've progressed.
We've been working on feet, footwork, and staying low, because that's a big part of what we do. Hands, keeping them inside, just proper technique.
The one returning guy that got a little sniff at times, Cy Martin's going to be a big player in this. Big-time baseball guy. Body's healed up. He's feeling really good. He's gotten really strong this summer, but he's the one that's got a little taste. You know, him and Barbera, Vance Crowe at center. Buchanan has kind of, you just watched him kind of come through the system, buy into the process, and has waited his time, and is really one that we find our offensive coaches talking about a lot.
Personally, I've been working on my kick step or on my kick slides and my post steps because I can't really get my jab quite timed up, and that's what it's been for our whole O-line.
I think it's slowly getting easier, which is how it should be. We're doing the same stuff, but we're getting used to it. We had a Nichols camp. That was a really good camp to have some new tools and stuff.
You know, kids are funny. They all say about the same thing, but they all say it differently. But if we're trying to get them to do one thing one way, and they hear it from a guy, from a coach at this camp, because they're so good at this camp that the kid gets it for us. I mean, heck, we roll with it.
I got better at connecting up, hitting, and driving through, correctly.
We started, we got there one night, we had one practice that night. It was okay, it was a good 2-hour break into what we're about to get into. But those 2-3 days that we had were brutal. I cannot express how much better I am now. My hand placement, my footwork, my hip twitch, just general mobility, it is exponentially better than it was to begin with.
I also worked on my drive in general, because whenever I first started playing the line, I was not very good. I was not very strong, and I wasn't just very strong-headed as well. And I grew myself at that camp.
It was intense. It was pretty hot. We were moving fast. You know, they upped the intensity more, to more of a college and higher level than we usually expect.
I learned pretty much anything you could imagine. There's all kinds of NFL and former college coaches that taught me a lot of information that was very crucial for my position. And it was very good with camaraderie. All of us coming together, it was a very difficult task for those 4 days. It's a lot of work, and you're very dehydrated and exhausted, but it's a very bonding experience to go through that together with all my buddies.
It's been really, really great to be a part of that growth. The culmination of this summer, of the arguably the hardest part of the year, preparing for the grind that is the football season, getting towards the end of it now. And so for them to kind of watch all this, us be a part of this growth, and watch them really start to come on their own, become confident in their ability, and also confident in what they can maximize and do, I think it's going to be really beneficial for us moving forward. We're going to ride or die with us. I'm going to tell you that. You know, and that's a mentality you have to build. That is an off-the-line culture. We're going to shoulder responsibility for where we're going to go as an offense. But at the end of the day, we're going to be defined on, can we run the ball, and can we physically impose our will and force another guy to tap against his own will, and we're going to be the ones for it to do that.
The point of people overlooking us, I think that kind of pisses us off a little bit, because we don't like being overlooked, and it kind of just gives us something to work for and prove people wrong.
I mean, if we don't have an O-line, we don't have an offense. They're just going to kill us if we don't have an O-line. So we have to have a strong O-line to even play football.
Kind of gave us a big underdog mentality with oh, that was the best O-line that Denham's ever had. Well, we're going to be the best that we've ever been, and we're going to try and disprove that and make it our own new best O-line.
I think we could be really special, especially in the run game, because, I mean, we all just have a underdog mentality, and we're all just ready to go out there and fight for each other.
I work hard. I do things the way I'm supposed to do it, how it's supposed to be done, when it's supposed to be done, because I demand that of myself, and I know that my team needs that. I'm going to sacrifice my own well-being and my body and my spirit for the better of us. I cannot give that to you. I want that for you. I want that for you. But until you desire that for yourself, we're going to be okay. And that's okay to be okay, unless you want to be great. All
right, let's go. Hey, bring it up, baby. Hogs, hey, let's get a hogs on one. One! Hogs!
Friday. Yeah. Hey, you gotta run, though, Jay.
Go!
Hey! Hey! Hey.
Good.
Big first step. Go! Big first step. Don't be afraid of the bar, Caden.
I do want to see his hand, and I got to beat him to that point. Beat him the point, see his hand. Whatever's there, take it.
The whole summer for us, kind of go back to the basics, just the fundamentals, the hand placement, the where our eyes are at. So for us, we kind of start back at just stage phase one. and we just kind of progress into that. So this is usually the summers where we do a lot of our teaching and learning. Everything's can slow down and we can actually learn how to play D-line.
Go! That ain't bad. Go!
It's been a lot of hard work. I mean, it's been from 6:30 to 9:30 and beyond, waking up early in the morning, getting to work, in that weight room, getting on the field, working for an extra hour or so, getting better with D-line technique, hand placement, quickness, ball get off, everything that has to be done.
It was a really tough month with conditioning, you know, getting right back into running, lifting heavy. We really pushed through with D-line, getting back to the stuff we always been doing. You know, same drills, really getting our craft together.
It's been hard, but it's been fun. Coming out here every morning, seeing your brothers, best friends, get to work. D-line's been working on a lot of pass rush and a lot of run fits, and it's just been a blast to come out here, learn, get better.
Been working a lot on pass rush, get that better. Our run fits are looking good. I feel like the only thing we need to work on really is double teams, but right now I feel like we'll be good.
First line of defense, so if we miss a tackle, let someone through, that they might take it to the house. So really this first roll of defense, so we gotta have our stuff together and be ready.
You know, we only got one starter, one and a half starters coming back on the D-line, and then everybody's new on the O-line. I like that challenge, but I think it doesn't really matter how much I like the challenge if these young guys don't embrace that challenge. And I say young just because they're inexperienced too, but we're gonna go where they take us. We're going to go where the nastier our trenches are, the better we're going to be.
I got a good, pretty good mix. I got a good group of bigs. Maybe some of them younger guys moved over from O-line. And then I've also got a little mix of little speed with Shaq and Debo and Kent and Foster and those guys.
Butler really blew onto the scene last year. Really became, it was kind of a question mark early, but got better and better every week. His growth was off the charts, and his play was off the charts.
So at the end of the year last year is when he really came in his own. You know, he started from day one, but he had a hard time making plays and kind of understanding how good he can be. But yeah, toward the end of the year, he became probably one of our better ones. We had a really stout D-line.
We've been working on like pass rush to get to a quarterback, ball get off, and like ball key, which we really need to work on for everybody on D-line. But yeah, we got to be really aggressive, like really mean up front, because if not, then you're going to get bullied. Guys going to blow right past you. Bad things gonna happen. So you really gotta be aggressive, really mean in the trenches. Like, it's really a fight.
We got Shaq, who's a returning starter, who's a dog. He's taking me under his wing a little bit with Lex.
You got Caden Davis, who split time at nose guard with Porter. That's kind of that one and that point five. He got enough quality reps to where he is a veteran and big old body, strong kids, had a heck of an offseason.
Caden may be the only kid that I have returning from last year that got some reps. Learned from some really good guys between Kimball and Porter Gibson and those guys.
Really, as a D-line, we need to get our run responsibilities right. Pass, we're pretty decent on pass. So we really just got our run responsibility right. Really just get explosive in the trenches and just not get blown back.
No, the goal is pretty much the same. Just do everything the baddest way you can. Like, be the baddest man on the field. I think we have the hardest job, you know.
We got Caden Davis coming in, stepping up at nose guard. We got Leon competing with him. Leon's also a dog. They're both two big physical guys.
We don't want to give no one no yards from run. Also, we're trying to sack the quarterback. So if we give you 1 yard, we might miss that tackle. We might not do our job, handle our gap, because we're one gap defense. We might not do our job. So we don't want no one else to get the sack. If we do our job, we should clog up all the holes and get no yards. And you know, defense win games.
We got me coming in for Alex, and I'm taking Debo under my wing, teaching him what Alex taught me, so I could be a role model for him, and he can teach the ones coming up.
Our key job is like to fill in our gaps so those linebackers and safeties can come down and, you know, maybe get a pick or get new tackles. I mean, really, you're really not really paid attention to that much, but it's really our job to, you know, fill in those gaps and all. So those linebackers can do their job, and if we mess up, we can potentially mess those people up.
We get overlooked a lot because we have really, really good back, like secondary with Deshaun and Rancher. We got Jonas, Kai, Trevor. D-line, we're up there when it comes to physicality and aggressiveness. And our role is huge because if we don't stop them, then we have to rely on 8 other guys to stop them.
I saw him turn his shoulder, and I was like, yeah, I got it.
Put your nose to the grindstone and just keep going. Just keep grinding, be a dog. It doesn't matter if you get looked at or not, you make the play, everybody's gonna hear you. Well, if I get on my job and like hold my gap, I can see where the running back is going to where if I need to shift over to get him, or if I need to stay in my spot so the linebacker can come down.
It's the most important thing. I don't know if maybe because that's the position I coach, but I don't know if it's cliche or, you know, that's what anybody you talk to that's a football guy. You win at the line of scrimmage. And I think that's O-line and D-line. I feel like we are the most important part. All the skilled players, they get all the praise and their names called out, but you know, those guys, if they don't have us, they're not gonna be very successful.
We don't get looked at as much as other people, but we are there. Like, most of the sacks or interceptions come from like us getting pressure or that, but we give the glory to a guy who get the pick or something like that. But yeah, we're definitely like background guys, but we still put that work in for the team to overall do good.
You don't see us. I mean, we're the O-line's parallel. We don't get the glory unless we get a sack, and that's not our job. Our job isn't to get the sack. Our job is to fill the gaps, put pressure on the quarterback. We're a gear that never stops running. We just get up, keep going. Our break is when we're off the field because we did our job.
I think what makes me most excited for this season, it's that it's my last high school season. And like, yeah, it's sad, but I'm excited for everything that comes with it and all the good, the bad, everything.
Those first few weeks, so much of it was just the teaching and the learning. And now it's almost like we're speeding that game up and getting more like game ready type stuff. Kind of just polishing everything up.
I don't know, the end of this week, and the summer's almost over, boys. We got a lot of work to get done here the next couple weeks.
I guess in the past I've been blessed with Alex Chandler and Porter Gibson, those guys that played for 3 years. Well, now there's a whole lot of bodies. So I don't even know if you ask who my top three are, I'm really not sure that is yet. I think it's gonna take a group effort. There may be 6 to 8 guys that have to help out this year for us to win the games we want to win.
Get D-line on one! D-line!
Cleared officially yesterday and was excited, and you know, I don't know how smart it was talking to the trainers. Even they kind of questioned me a little bit about getting him some reps, but it is the last one, and you know, he's chomping at the bit. He's done everything we've asked him to do, so if we can't reward him with just a handful of snaps to let him get comfortable, you know, his presence is really key for us, and you can see a difference in outside linebacker play when he was in. When you get on the field, you take advantage of the opportunity and you get the damn job done. Or you back your ass out of the way. If you don't want to be here and play, go home. Go home. If you don't feel good, go home. This is the last one. It's been a long June. You're tired. Why? Because we're competing. Get out there and do your damn job and compete and fight your ass off. Am I clear? Play. Play. Play.
Get it up.
I stand first.
Make the fucking hard work. 1, 2, 3.
Hard work.
Go!
I told you I'm right here.
When we're in that locker room hanging out before, you have an awesome energy about you. You have this competitive look in your eye, right? When you're in the weight room, you have all this energy, and you feel really good about yourself, right? But think about it. Look, it's everybody. You have this swag about you, this confidence. Somewhere from when we leave there, make the walk right there, our confidence becomes kind of a fake confidence. It exposes those guys that are confident in what they do, confident in how they prepare, confident in how they study, confident in the playbook and what the job we're asking you to do. When you are confident in that, you come out of that house completely different. Because if you're not confident, you become that fake hard, that fake, or you get so down on yourself so quick things get a little rough and you're not near as good. You put a ceiling on yourself that's nowhere near what you're 100% capable of doing. There's a standard there. And either you can absolutely reach the standard or reset it, or you cannot. Either you want to play and compete or you cannot. But your confidence, who you are and what you want to be, that's a decision you make, and we got to continue to keep beating on that craft and getting that better. There's a confidence we've got to get together. There's a confidence you got to have in yourself. There's a confidence you got to have in the man next to you. There's a confidence in the man you got to have across the ball from you. And that can't be fake when you come out of the house. Understood? Hey, seniors, that was it. There's your 7-on-7 season. It's over. Last time as a high school kid. You know, we might have some more 7-on-7s, but it ain't going to be our Wednesday league, usually at 10:30. Seniors, you just completed it. So another part of the old career knocked off, and you see how fast it's going. By the way, after tomorrow, June's over. Got a nice beach day tomorrow. Make sure we finish up. We got to get comfortable finishing up the week. We're always our best on Thursday and Fridays, right? Hey, I'm proud of you. Keep grinding. Clean this film up. Clean these mistakes up. Trust us. Trust each other. We're going to be kicking people's ass here real soon. Good? Let's get a break.
Let's go, babe.
Everybody up. Let's get a family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family!
The heat's critical right now. It's tough. It's tough on these kids, and you know, we got to be smarter. You know, we don't want to put any of these kids in a situation where we harm them or hurt them. You know, you try to be overly tough by fighting the heat. There's no sense in all that when we can go early or later. So we got the schools to agree to come in early so we can knock it out before it gets out of control. You know, I think a very successful 7-on-7 month and season. You know, really excited about for where we finished. But there's still a lot of growth to be had, and we just got to continue to get better and continue to get comfortable and get back to figuring out how to run the football as well. When we talk about confidence there at the end, you know, on the flip side, you talk about the ones that do have that confidence. You see a big change in his game and his play because of his confidence. You know, he struggled catching a football in the spring. After he got his eyes looked at and he got that corrected, I guess, he's seeing the football, he's catching the football, and because of his confidence, he's really becoming a complete player and playing at a different level than everybody else. A short week with the 4th of July where it falls. But, you know, you got to get their mind right. You try to get them to taper down on the other sports. I'm not saying don't play other sports, but sometimes you got to look in the mirror and you got to give yourself a chance to be physically and mentally well to go through what a football season is and a grind. And you know, you're talking, we have goals to play 15 weeks. We're not trying to play 10 anymore around here. So, you know, you got to take this month to really get your mind right, get your body right, and you continue to get, you know, better, get in better shape. You continue to get stronger. But, you know, mentally and everything else, you're really fine-tuning your craft as you gear up for the season.
Jump, 3.
Jump.
4.
Jump.
5.
I don't hear you, Deshaun.
6.
Jump.
7.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You
5, 4,
start over!
Hey. Y'all can't jump it, Jake?
Just, hey, get some rhythm. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But it's out. One, you count when you clap together.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Tires gonna be in the middle. You are pulling. You are pulling against each other. This way and this way. Get the tire to the cone.
Trevor's a little bit lower to the ground. Center of gravity's a little bit lower. I really think Deshaun's got a chance though.
I got Reese counts.
Reese?
Yeah.
I got Reese too.
He's got a little bit of dog.
The jump squad!
So guys.
And you're gonna do some special things. You understand that?
Yes, sir.
Keep working together, keep pushing each other. Iron sharpens iron. When you all become your best, we're gonna be really special.
Great, we're great. I wish I would have gone, but it was fun picking a side and seeing who was going to win, cheering on your teammates.
You know, I really had a fight, had to get that initial contact, and then it was just downhill from there. Just stay tight, stay focused, get the job done.
You know, they don't want the smoke. I can't let these dudes, you know, get hurt, so I can't compete.
I believe first we have the Army run, in which our strapping young lads will find out what it's like to decipher minefield issues on top of hustling in between court to court.
It's fun though, actually. I like it.
I could 1v1 a gorilla.
Really?
Maybe like moral support.
Alright, so if it's a 3v1 versus gorilla in a tire fight, what do you think, Jerry?
Who's winning?
Boss.
Wow. Okay.
I'll make Get
away, man.
So we're jumping. Everybody's getting knees to the chest every time. All right, Jerry, you're gonna lead it.
One, jump.
One,
jump.
Two,
jump.
Three,
jump.
Four,
jump.
Five,
jump.
Six,
seven,
jump.
Eight,
jump.
Nine,
jump.
Ten,
jump.
One,
jump.
Two,
jump.
Three,
jump.
Four,
jump.
Five.
if everybody does them in unison, everybody counts. We do it perfect the first time. We only got 10. Somebody messes it up, we start over.
Count when your feet get back together. Ready? Begin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Begin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All right, Ben and Dahl didn't get his hands high every time.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Bowman.
Let's go.
Ready? Begin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Close. When you clap together, that's 1, 2, 3.
I better hear you.
All right, right in position. Ready? Begin.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Get down.
Let's go. Get out.
Offense.
You get the whole tire pass, or he lets go, then you win. What?
Person, any comment?
Fresh legs, man. Fresh legs.
Fresh legs. A bunch of excuses.
He's not even Sydnie. I just went through a whole workout. Did you even show up this morning?
Did you even do a workout?
I just work harder than you, so I was tired.
Right.
That's just how it is.
You don't work harder.
You have to take care of each other. You're doing a hell of a job. July is going to fly by, and we're playing football before you know it.
How many people did you battle? Some of them.
I'm great. Good beef steak. Aloha.
It went pretty good. You know, they threw a curveball. I had to go against my best friend RJ, but I'm kind of proud of him because I gave everything I got, so I know he gave everything he got.
Mentally, and trying to enhance their competitiveness, let them, you know, teach them how to have some fun, but you know, competing at a high level is what makes it fun. And to see them get out there and get after each other on that tire tug of war, and to push each other, to pull for each other, you know, I would say successfully, what a great week too, and looking forward to part 3.
Happy birthday, Grimace.
Hey, let's
That's it.
DSTV's production of Summer Season is brought to you by The Block Nutrition. Tired and drained after a hot summer day? Come to The Block Nutrition for a refreshing, loaded tea or hydration, because The Block is always hot.